Om Shanti. Today's Murli, dated 28th September 2020. Sweet Baba says, sweet children, you are true friends with the whole world. You should have no enmity with anyone. So, those who are true friends, not only friends, but true friends with the whole world, cannot have enmity with any soul who is also a part of this world, right? And why are we the true friends? Because it is said, a friend in need is a friend indeed. And we are the friends who salvage this world in this hour of need. So we are the true friends of the whole world. We cannot have enmity towards any soul in this world. Question: you are the spiritual military. What direction has the Father given you, which you have to put into practice? So Baba says, you have been given the direction, always wear your badge. Just like people in the military always put on their badge and they were very proud to do so, we should also be very proud to wear the badge which reflects that we are working for the Supreme Father. Whenever anyone asks you what it is or who you are, so if someone asks you your introduction or asks you to introduce the badge about what it is, then what do you say? So see what Baba teaches us. So you know, just like parents teach their children how to talk, so Baba is also teaching us how to talk. So Baba says, tell them, we are the fire brigade who puts out the fire of lust of the whole world. At this time, the whole world is ablaze with the fire of lust. We are giving everyone the message, now become pure and imbibe divine virtues and your boat will go across. So just like when you want to extinguish fire, you have to pour water. Similarly, the fire of lust, which is because of which the whole world is ablaze or burning right now, can only be put out if you pour the water of purity. So when every soul adopts this virtue of purity, only then will the fire of lust will be put out from this whole world. Om Shanti. Sweetest spiritual children are sitting in easy remembrance. Are you sitting in easy remembrance? Yes, because in yesterday's Murli, Baba said that love is the foundation of easy remembrance. So because we love Baba, we experience a relationship with Baba, and we experience that the foundation of all our attainments is Baba, and we feel that Baba is the whole world to us, so remembrance of Baba is very easy to us. Some find it difficult. Many are confused because they think that they have to sit in a very tight or strict manner. The Father says, there is nothing like that here. So you just have to sit still, but not tight or strict. You can be very relaxed because you have to remember Baba with love, with a feeling of relationship and attainment. and it has got nothing to do with the tightness of the body. So Baba says, you may sit how you like. You simply have to remember the Father. There is no question of difficulty in this. Hatha yogis sit in a very tight position, crossing one leg over the other. Here, the Father tells you to sit comfortably. Remember the Father and the cycle of 84 births. So Baba says, just detach from this old world, unplug your buddhi from here, and just remember Baba and your cycle of 84 births by pulling your attention away from this world and orienting it towards Baba and your journey. So this doesn't have anything to do with the body. It is what the soul does with the mind and intellect. This is easy remembrance. While sitting and walking around, this should remain in your intellects. Just as this little boy is sitting next to his father and he is only aware of his parents. So you see, there is a little boy sitting in front of Baba, and Baba says, you see, this little boy is sitting beside his father and he is only remembering his parents. He is only in awareness of his parents, because for a little child, his whole universe are his parents. He feels a sense of all relationships with his parents, and he feels that whatever he has to get or whatever he needs can be provided fully by parents. So when we experience this kind of a sense of relationship and a feeling that whatever I need will be provided by Baba, then I will be like a small child who is only in awareness of his parents. So Baba says, so you too are children, and it is therefore easy to remember the Father. We are Baba's children. Do you know how to become a child? So everybody says that God is the Father. But in order to connect with the Father, we should know how to become a child. And for a child, his parents are the whole world to him. So similarly, when we experience that Baba is all I have, can I become a child to Baba? And only then can I experience Baba as my father. So Baba says, we are Baba's children. We have to claim our inheritance from Baba. So for claiming our inheritance, we have to become like Baba. And the rule says, you become like the one you remember. So if I stay in awareness of Baba, if I always remember Baba, I become like him and I become qualified to claim my inheritance from Baba. So Baba says, you may live at home with your families and carry on working for your livelihoods, but simply remove the remembrance of others from your intellects. So Baba says, it's not a question of where your physical body is. You may live at home, you may be surrounded by family members, but what you have to do is, with your buddhi, you also always have to remember Baba. Some of you used to remember Hanuman and others used to remember sages, etc. That remembrance has to be forgotten. Everyone remembers someone. So this art of remembrance is not new to us. It's just that earlier we remembered those who are themselves impure or in sorrow or in some low degree of perfection. So by remembering them, we became like them. And now we have to remember the one who is the supreme, the perfect, the ocean. So we just have to change our remembrance. And remembrance is not something new. Everyone remembers someone. Worshippers go to temples in order to carry out their worship. Here there is no need to go anywhere. Tell anyone you meet, Shiv Baba says, remember me, the one father. Just be where you are and just know that you belong to Baba and remember him. Shiv Baba is incorporeal. So when you have to remember a child, you become a child, right? Only then your frequency matches with the frequency of the child. Similarly, because Shiv Baba is incorporeal, you also come to the awareness that I am incorporeal. And then you can remember the incorporeal very easily. He definitely has to come into the corporeal world to say, constantly remember me alone. This is so interesting that Baba has to take a body to speak and let us know that you are not a body and I'm not a body and you become bodiless and remember me the bodiless. So Baba says, I am the purifier. So because Baba is the purest of pure, the ocean of purity, that is why by remembering him, we become pure. So in that sense, he is the purifier. This word is right. Baba says, remember me, all of you are impure. This is the impure and tamo pradhan world. This is why Baba says, don't remember any bodily being. So you see, in this world where everybody is impure and degraded, their thoughts, words, and actions are also of the same quality. Now just pay attention to the news that you're watching these days. So you are thinking about the impure thoughts that other people are thinking. You are thinking about the impure actions, the degraded acts that people in all strata are doing. So when you think about that, those actions, those thought processes become a part of your mind and they start coloring you. So Baba says, whenever you remember anybody in this degraded and impure world, you also start becoming like that. This is why this world is getting impure by impure with every passing second, because we are all thinking about the actions performed by degraded human beings. So Baba says, now you just unplug. Don't think about any bodily being. Just think about me. So Baba says, this is why Baba says, don't remember any bodily being. It is a good thing, is it not, that no guru etc. is praised here. So there is no need for you to remember any guru, anybody who is in the body. You just have to remember Shiv Baba who doesn't have a body. The father says, simply remember me and your sins will be cut away. This is the power of the fire of yoga. So just like when you light a fire, then anything that goes into the fire changes its form and shape. Similarly, when you sit in yoga, it is like a fire. And with the company of Shiv Baba, all that is inside the soul, the old belief systems, the old sanskars, old ways of thinking, they start getting changed. They change their shape and form in the fire of yoga. So Baba says, the unlimited father is telling the truth, is he not? when he says that the God of Gita is the incorporeal one. So in the Gita it is mentioned that if you remember me, your sins will be cut away. So your sins will be cut away only when you remember the one who is incorporeal, because only then you will rise above your body consciousness, which is actually the root of all your sins. So Baba says, only by remember the one who doesn't have a body can you overcome your body consciousness. So definitely the speaker of the Gita should be the incorporeal one and not corporeal Shri Krishna. So Baba says, it is not a question of Krishna being this. God says, simply remember me alone. There is no other method. By returning home pure, you will claim a high status. So if you purify yourself with yoga, then you will come in Satyug and have a high status. Otherwise also you will go home. But then if you don't purify yourself with the fire of yoga, then you will be purged by punishment. And when you do that, you will not claim a high status in the new world. So Baba says, otherwise your status will be reduced. I am giving you the Father's message. So always tell people that it is not something that we are saying, it's the Father's message, your Father's message, and I am a messenger. There is no difficulty in explaining this. Women, stone intellects, hunchbacks can also claim a high status, whether you live here or at home with your family. It isn't that those who live here stay in remembrance more. No. Anybody living anywhere, anybody having any past, anybody having any kind of physical deformity it is not that they are not given the right to claim their inheritance. So everybody has equal right, and only if they engage in the right process, which is remember Baba accurately, that they will claim their inheritance. So Baba says, those who live outside can also stay in remembrance a great deal and do a lot of service. Some come here and become refreshed by the Father and then return home. Therefore, they should have so much happiness inside. So you can come to Baba, fill yourself with happiness, go home, remember Baba, and also be at his service. There are only a few more days in this dirty world, and we will then go to the land of Krishna. So, because Shri Krishna is the first prince of Satyug, so there are only few days in this dirty world, and then we will be going to Satyug, which is the land of Krishna. So Baba says, even Krishna's temple is called the land of happiness, that is Sukh Dham. So Baba says, in this Kali Yuga also, Krishna's temple is referred to as Sukh Dham. So actually Sukh Dham or Satyug is the abode of Shri Krishna, and we will be going there shortly. Therefore, since you children now belong to the unlimited Father, you should experience limitless happiness. You were made into the masters of heaven. You also say, Baba, I met you 5,000 years ago and I will meet you again. You have to be victorious over Maya by remembering the Father. So when you remember the Father, you are more powerful than Maya, because you are with the Almighty. You no longer want to stay in this land of sorrow. Do you want to stay in this land of sorrow? Baba says you no longer want to stay in this land of sorrow. You are studying in order to go to the land of happiness. Everyone has to settle his or her accounts and then return home. And we can settle these accounts by two methods, with the power of yoga. And when we have the power of yoga, the settlements that come up for settlement will look very tiny, and we will cross them with the power of yoga. Otherwise, if we don't cultivate the power of yoga, then whatever comes up for settlement will look like a big obstacle. And then we will have to suffer in that situation, and by suffering we will settle that settlement. So Baba says, you have two ways to settle your accounts. One is with the power of yoga, another is by suffering. So you can choose, but this is the time to settle accounts and go. And nobody, even if they don't want to go back, they have to go back, because this is the time of return journey. I have come to establish the new world. All the rest of the souls will go and stay in the land of liberation. So those who suffer and settle their accounts at the end will go to the land of liberation, and those who cultivate divine virtues and settle their accounts with the power of yoga will go to Sukhdham, that is Satyug. The father says, I am the death of deaths. I free all souls from their bodies and take them all back home with me. Everyone asks to go back soon because they don't want to live here. This is an old world and an old body. So everybody says, please God, take me away. The father now says, I will take everyone back with me. I will not leave anyone behind. All of you called out to me, O purifier, come. People don't understand the meaning of that, although they continue to remember me. And when was purification an easy process? So people keep saying, O purifier, come, but they do not understand who they are calling and what they are signing up for. So if one has to become pure, then one has to actually go through the whole purging process to get rid of impurities. So Baba says, only with the fire of yoga can you become pure. So Baba says, people don't understand the meaning of that, although they continue to remember me. They chant the name of the purifier, referring to King Ram of the warrior clan of the Silver Age. Shiv Baba neither becomes a king nor rules a kingdom. So Baba says, they say Raja Ram. So Ram is the king. So Baba says, I am Ram because you are Sita. So all the scriptures are the story of souls and God. So soul is Sita and God or the Supreme Soul is Ram. But Baba says, I don't become the king ever. This is how they remember God. So Baba says, it is wrong to call him King Ram. When they turn the beads of a rosary, they say Ram's name. So when they churn the rosary, they keep saying Ram, Ram, Ram. So Baba says, this is how they remember God. God is Shiva, because the beads of the rosary stand for the incorporeal. So the bead is like a small point, and that is a symbol of the incorporeal God. And when they churn the bead, they say this is Ram, Ram. So what they are actually referring to is Shiv Baba, who is incorporeal. Human beings have given him many names. They even call Krishna by many names. Shyam Sundar, Baikunt Nath, meaning the Lord of Paradise, Makhan Chor, the one who stole butter, etc. Would you say Krishna was someone who stole butter? Not at all, because Krishna belongs to the land of prosperity. He is the master of the land of prosperity. So why would he require to steal anything? You now understand that God is incorporeal. No bodily being can be God. If even Brahma, Vishnu and Shankar cannot be called God, how can human beings call themselves to be God? The rosary of victory of 108 of the Father is remembered. So Baba says, along with Shiv Baba, 108 souls participated in this task of world transformation completely. So they made as much effort as Shiv Baba. So that is why 108 souls are remembered with Shiv Baba in the rosary. Shiv Baba established heaven. They were the masters of that heaven. Who? Lakshmi and Narayan. So Baba says God is the generator, operator and destroyer. He generates the new world and destroys the old world and takes care of the sustenance of the new world through Vishnu. But Baba says that I am the one who involves and engages Brahma, Vishnu, Shankar in this process. But Brahma, Vishnu, Shankar are not God. They are agents of God who carry out his task. So Baba says even Brahma, Vishnu and Shankar are not God. And Lakshmi Narayan, whose combined swarup is Vishnu, is are actually the rulers of heaven. So Baba says they must definitely have made effort prior to that. That is called the confluence age. So Baba says when Satyug starts, then Lakshmi and Narayan are the masters of that heaven. And before Satyug, there is Kaliyug. So there must be a phase between Kaliyug and Satyug where souls made this effort whereby they could become the masters of heaven. So Baba says that time between Kaliyug and Satyug is called the confluence age, between the end of the Iron Age and the beginning of the Golden Age. It is the confluence of all cycles. However, those people then spoke of a confluence of every age. They said God comes yuge yuge, which means he came after Satyug, he came after Treta Yug, he came after Dwapar Yug. But if God came at the end of every age, then why was there descent, gradual descent with every age? So if God comes, then God is the one who finishes all religions and establishes one world, one religion. So then why the world kept getting fragmented and we kept getting depleted with every passing age? So Baba says, no, I come only at the end of Kaliyug and establish Satyug. I don't come at the end of every age. They forgot that they called him the incarnation and said that he was in the pebbles and stones and in every speck of dust. Baba says that too is in the drama. So Baba says, I don't mind because I never think about what happened in the past. I only focus on what you need to do in the moment. So Baba says, all this happened, you called Baba in that he is in pebbles and stones. Now you see, if somebody told you, you are a pebble, then you will take this as an insult, but you say God is a pebble. So Baba says, God the highest of high and how we addressed him, but Baba doesn't think about it because he says that was drama. And by saying the word drama, he puts a full stop or stops thinking about that. And Baba says, anything that becomes the past is called drama. after there has been a quarrel with someone, that has become the past. So what you do? You put a full stop to it and start afresh in this present second. Because this present second, this now, is a very valuable gift. Don't waste it by thinking about what happened in the past second. So Baba says, therefore, you mustn't think about it. Achha, if someone said something or other, just forget it. He said the same thing in the previous cycle also. And just remember that in the previous cycle also, you put a full stop and moved on. If you remember it, you continue to become upset. So you are the one who becomes the instrument of carrying the pain in the past second into the present and in the future. So you stop giving continuity to that pain. So Baba says, don't even speak about it again. You children have to do service, do you not? So children who have a job, who are at service, and that too godly service, cannot afford to get stuck in these thoughts of the past and worries of the future and thinking about what other people are doing, because we have greater things to attend to. There shouldn't be any obstacles to service. So our own mind sometimes becomes an obstacle to service because we serve through the mind. So if our mind is stuck in the past or thinking about somebody's unfair actions, then this mind is not capable of doing service, and it actually becomes an obstacle in service. You mustn't show any weakness in service. It is Shiv Baba's service, is it not? You must never refuse to do it. A child of Shiv Baba never refuses to do his service because he knows this is the service of the Godfather, the Supreme. And anybody who refuses to obey the Supreme or actually goes against God. So no child of God can afford to go against God. So never refuse to do his service. Otherwise, you will destroy your own status. You have become the Father's helpers. Therefore, you have to give him complete help. You mustn't even slightly deceive the Father in doing his service. Don't deceive him. Don't cheat on his service. Because he is the one who is going to give you everything. So if you cheat him, you cheat yourself. The message has to be given to everyone. It is our duty to share Baba's message of that Baba says, remember me and become pure with every soul on the planet. So Baba says, the Father continues to say, give the museum such a name that when people see it, they will be pulled to enter it. So when you establish a museum where there are all the pictures and you are explaining the pictures and giving Baba's knowledge, then you should make the entrance of that museum very attractive so that people want to enter it, and only when they enter it can you serve them spiritually. So Baba says that give the museum such a name that when people see it, they will be pulled to enter it and can thereby come to understand. This is something new. And when people see something new, that they immediately enter. Nowadays, people come from abroad to learn the ancient yoga of Bharat. Now, ancient yoga means that yoga which Shiv Baba taught 5,000 years ago, which he is teaching right now. But instead of teaching that ancient yoga, sannyasis are teaching Hatha yoga instead and fooling people. So Baba says, ancient means द ओल्डेस्ट ऑफ ऑल. दैट कैन ओनली बी द योगा टॉट बाय गॉड विच ही टॉट 5,000 ईयर्स अगो. देर इज नो योग इन द गोल्डन एंड सिल्वर एजेस. द वन हु टॉट यू वेंट अवे. बाबा गोज अवे आफ्टर द कॉन्फ्लुएंस एज. सो इन द गोल्डन एंड सिल्वर एज देर इज नो योग. एंड इन द कॉपर एंड आयरन एज देर इज ओनली हट योग taught by sannyasis. And only when Baba comes again in the confluence age does he teach you Raj Yoga, which is the king of all yogas. So Baba says, only when he comes again after 5,000 years does he teach Raj Yoga. Ancient means 5,000 years old, when God taught it. That same God will then come at the confluence age once again and then again teach you Raj Yoga through which you can become pure, just like he is teaching now. So Baba says, at this time even the elements are tamo pradhan. The five elements, they have also become impure and degraded, tamo pradhan. Even water causes so much damage. Calamities continue to happen in the old world. In the golden age, there is no question of calamities. There, nature becomes your servant. So now, because the masters have lost their mastery over their senses, so the servants, which are the five elements of nature, are in that state of fury. And when the masters become masters again, then the servants also are put in their place. So Baba says, here nature becomes your enemy and causes sorrow. There was no question of sorrow in the kingdom of Lakshmi and Narayan. That was the golden age, the age of truth. This is now being established once again. The father is teaching you ancient Raj Yoga, and he will teach it again after 5,000 years. Whatever part someone has, he will play that same part again, because this whole drama is repeated identically, second by second. The unlimited father is also playing his part. The father says, I enter this one, Brahma Baba, carry out establishment and then return home. After the cries of distress, there will be cries of victory. So you have to keep making effort in this time of distress and then you will be victorious. The old world will be destroyed. When it was the kingdom of Lakshmi and Narayan, the old world didn't exist. It is a matter of 5,000 years ago only. It cannot be a matter of hundreds of thousands of years. Because if it was a matter of hundreds of thousands of years, the population would be much greater than it is now. The father says, in order to benefit yourself, forget everything else and engage yourself in this service. So Baba says, this is the moment to be on service and earn the income by doing this punya karam. So Baba says, don't lose this second in thinking about people, places, things, past, future and the other. Just concentrate this second in and use it for service. So just withdraw your attention from everything else, forget everything and else and use this second for service. So Baba says, forget everything and just do service. Baba says, don't sulk and then become deceitful in the service you do. So Baba says, don't cheat Baba by being faithful to people who are not faithful to you. So this is God's service. There will be many storms of Maya, but don't deceive anyone in God the Father's service. The Father continues to give you directions for the sake of service. You are true friends of anyone who comes, even your friends and relatives. So you are friends with each and every soul in the world. So your friends and relatives are also part of this world. So you cannot be an enemy to them. You Brahma Kumars and Kumaris are friends with the whole world because you are the father's helpers. There should be no enmity among friends. If something happens, just say, remember Shiv Baba. Engage yourself in following the father's Srimad. Otherwise, you will cause yourself a loss. So just give them an indication that you don't cause yourself loss. Don't blame them for what they did to you. Just tell them that they shouldn't cause a loss to themselves by engaging in such an action. When you come here by train, you are all free. Yes, so in a train, everybody is sitting idle. So what do you think Baba is trying to tell us? So Baba says, there on the train, you can serve people by using your badge, because your badge has all the pictures. So you can use these pictures and serve people spiritually by letting them know their identity, their father's identity on the train itself. So Baba says, you have a very good chance to do service. The badge is a very good thing. Each one of you definitely has to wear it. But when you wear a badge, you represent Shiv Baba and the organization Brahma Kumaris. So when you represent Baba and the Yajna, you have to be very careful. Because if you wear a badge and then you do something that a Brahma Kumar or Kumari is not expected to do, then you defame the father and the whole Yajna. So Baba says, every child of Shiv Baba must wear the badge and also fulfill the responsibility that comes with the badge. So Baba says, when someone asks who you are, tell them, we are the fire brigade. That fire brigade puts out fires. The whole world is now burning in the fire of lust. The father now says, conquer lust, the greatest enemy. Remember the father and become pure. So the father doesn't have a body. So he doesn't have any lust. He's the ocean of purity. And I, the soul, am his child. I do not have a body myself. This body is just what I have taken in this world. So there is no question of any bodily attraction or need or lust. So by remembering who you are and who you belong to, conquer lust. So Baba says, remember the father and become pure. Imbibe divine virtues and your boat will go across. These badges have been created according to Srimad. Very few children do service using the badge. Baba explains to you so many times in the Murlis. Every Brahmin should have a badge. Explain the badge to whomever you meet. This is Baba. So in the badge, there's a picture of Baba. So explain, this is Baba. You have to remember him. We are not praising the corporeal one. The bestower of salvation for all is the one incorporeal father. And it is he who has to be remembered. Your sins will be cut away with the power of yoga. And your final thoughts will then lead you to your destination. So when you, the soul, are free of sins, then in your final moment, you will have only thoughts of purity, and then you will create the destiny of going to the pure world as soon as you leave your body. So Baba says, you will be liberated from the land of sorrow, and you will then go to the land of Vishnu. This is such good news. You can also give them some literature. Now, when you give anybody literature, So mostly, you know, people are very concerned about things that are free these days. So people want everything free. Even those who can afford want it free, because there's a lot of greed and miserliness as a sanskar in people. So Baba says, you tell them that because you are poor, we will give it to you free of charge. So if you can't afford it, it is free. But if you have been given the affordability by the universe, so if you are fortunate enough to be able to afford, then you should not only pay for that, but you should also provide for those who can't afford to pay for themselves. So Baba says, if you are poor, we will give it to you free. Wealthy ones should give some money, because plenty have to be printed. So any seva requires money. So those who can't afford it can take it free, because every child of Baba has a right to take Baba's knowledge. But those who can afford should not only compensate for the seva they take, but also ensure that they provide so much that other people who can't afford can also take the benefit of this knowledge. So Baba says, this is such that you can change from a beggar and become a master of the world. So this kind of a seva should always be funded by people who can afford it. You continue to receive these explanations. Tell anyone of any religion. In fact, you are a soul. So whether they belong to any religion is immaterial, because they are a soul. Consider yourself to be a soul and remember the Father. Destruction is now just ahead. This world is going to change. If you remember Shiv Baba, you will go to the land of Vishnu. Tell them, we are giving you something that is worth millions and billions. Baba has told you so many times that you have to serve using your badge. But some of you don't even wear your badge because you are too embarrassed. Now, we are not embarrassed to do all the evil acts that we do, but we are embarrassed to belong to Baba. So this is what you know Maya has done to our buddhi. When Brahmin teachers come here with a group, or when they go to work on their own, they should definitely be wearing this badge. When you explain this badge to people, they will become very happy. Tell them, we only believe in the one Father. Only He can give everyone peace and happiness. Therefore, remember Him. Souls cannot return home impure. This old world is now going to change. While you are coming here, you should do service in this manner along the way. So Baba says, when you are going to Mount Abu by train, keep serving people on the way. Your name will be glorified a great deal. Baba understands that you are perhaps too embarrassed to wear your badge, and that is why you don't do any service. So Baba says, this is what children have come to. They are embarrassed to wear a badge. They are embarrassed to do service. So that means you are embarrassed of God. Then how can God give you anything if you are embarrassed of Him? So Baba says, firstly, you should have the badge. Then together with this, you should have pictures of the Trimurti, the cycle, and the tree. Sit amongst yourself and explain to one another, and many will gather around you. When they ask, what is this? Tell them, Shiv Baba is establishing the new world through this one, Brahma. So in the Trimurti, there is Shiv Baba, Brahma, Vishnu, Shankar. So explain, this is Shiv Baba incorporeal establishing through Brahma, and the world that will be established will be ruled by Sri Lakshmi and Sri Narayan, whose combined form is Vishnu. So Baba says, have all these pictures and explain on the way. The father says, now remember me and become pure, and also tell them the way in which they can go to that world. Impure souls cannot return home. Tell them such sweet things that everyone listens in great happiness. However, this doesn't sit in anyone's intellect. So we listen to the Murli, but I don't know how much the Murli sits in our intellect. Because if something gets imbibed in the intellect, then it reflects in our actions. When you go to your center for class, you should always wear a badge. Military people always wear their badge. Are they ever too embarrassed to wear it? You are the spiritual military. The father is giving you directions. So why don't you put them into practice? So how can you afford to disobey the directions of God? When you wear your badge, you will be able to remember Shiv Baba. I am a child of Shiv Baba. Day by day, centers will continue to open. Someone or other will emerge. They will say, you don't have a branch in this town. Tell them, if someone makes arrangements and invites us to come and offers us accommodation, we can come and do service here. When children have courage, the father helps. So any child who offers to take care of Baba's center, to provide accommodation so that Baba's services can take place, that child is definitely helped by Baba. So if the child shows courage, then Baba helps. The father only tells you children to open centers and do service because you are the children. So Baba has a right on you because he is giving you his everything. So therefore, he gives you the direction to serve others. All of these are Shiv Baba's shops. So Shiv Baba's shops where the jewels of knowledge are given out. They are being run by the children. Acha, to the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance, and good morning from the mother, the father, Bap Dada. The spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children also say namaste to the spiritual father. So essence for dharna is never sulk among yourselves and be deceitful in service. Don't become an obstacle. Don't show your weaknesses, but become the father's complete helpers. After there has been a quarrel with someone, that has become the past. Therefore, you mustn't think about it. Someone may have said something or the other, but you should forget it. He said the same thing in the previous cycle, so never mention it again. The blessing is, may you have pure and positive thoughts for others, and by being merciful, merge the things of the past. So Baba says, when someone comes to you to tell you about someone else's weaknesses of the past, then with good wishes, step aside. So Baba says, don't listen to that person talking about anybody else's weakness. And also don't pay attention to his weakness that he's talking about other person's weakness. So just step aside with good wishes. Let there not be any wasteful thinking or any talk about weaknesses among yourselves. Be careful, be merciful and merge the things of the past. So whatever has happened. Never think about it. Merge those things and with good wishes, continue to serve that soul with your mind. So even if that soul is paying attention to somebody's weakness, you pay attention to his qualities and just have good wishes for this soul. Even if someone is saying, doing or listening to something wrong, due to the influence of their sanskars, transform that one by having good wishes for them. Do not allow a rosary of such wasteful matters to be created, because you know, it just keeps spreading from one to the other. So don't create a rosary of waste by spreading from one to two to three in this way. To pay such attention means to have pure and positive thoughts. Slogan: be a jewel of contentment and you will be loved by God, by the people and by the self. So everyone loves a content soul. God loves them, everybody loves them, and you also love yourself when you have this quality of contentment. Om Shanti.